If you're having a hard time keeping up with your never-ending to-do lists and priorities on your interior design projects, you feel disorganized, it's sometimes hard to keep up with deadlines, then this video is for you. Between client presentations, issuing construction drawings, sourcing products and ordering and keeping track of the orders, there's so many things that you need to be doing for your interior design projects. And it's really hard if you don't have a sound process for keeping track of everything that needs to be done. Having a clear process for managing your projects is not just handy, but it's going to make you feel like you're in control, like you're organized, you're more efficient, and you're going to provide a top-notch client experience. And today, I want to show you how we set up our interior design clients so that they can manage those projects more efficiently. We're going to jump on the computer, and I'm going to show you the template that we use for all our clients. It's in ClickUp. ClickUp is a project management tool, so I've got Dubsado. This is for the client management tool. ClickUp we use as a project management tool, and the template that we use is very easy. If you are interested in purchasing it, I'm going to link it down below. It's in our shop. It's under $100, so it's very cheap for what you get. And I'm pretty sure that it's going to change the way that you manage projects from now on. All right, we are in my ClickUp dashboard. So this is the app, but you can open ClickUp on your browser as well. So this is not relevant to this video. This is my own stuff. When you download our template, this is what you get. So you're going to get a space, which is for project management, and you're going to see different folders. So you're going to see a folder for clients, and this is where you're going to have all your client projects. You're going to use this template, duplicate, and then have a different name for different clients. And this is where you're going to be able to manage your client projects. And then you're going to see a folder called procurement and order tracking, which I will go into in a minute. And this is where you're going to be able to keep track of your the procurement phase of your projects. So let's get into this list first. So you will duplicate this, duplicate, here you go. So you keep everything the same, and then we're going to put client A. We're going to copy everything. Okay, so we have our client A, and this is where you're going to be able to start adding information for this specific client. But if you look at this, you have different things going on. First of all, the different views that you have the list, which is the most convenient for this template. You can view everything in board view. So this is per status, to do, working on, waiting for feedback, waiting on clients. So this is a different view depending on what you like best. You can also view everything in the calendar view to see when things are due. So this is convenient. And then the table that we're not going to look at. So if we go back to the list view, the way we set it up is the first kind of section is information. So you could add the information, the general information about the project. So for instance, if there's a Google Drive folder that you use for this project, you can add it here. You can add the scope of Word document. You can add the contract if you want to have it handy on here. Anything that you want to have easily accessible from the dashboard. Then any documents relating to project management admin. So for example, weekly updates, ClickUp boards for this client. So anything that you think you might want. And before I go through everything, I just want to share. So you have different sections and then you have different columns here. So if you look here, you have the priority. So you can change the priority, whether it's urgent or low. So at a glance, you can see what is high priority that you need to have a look at this week. This, we just added, if you have someone you delegate drawings to or anything else, maybe a VA, anyone that you delegate to and you want to be a little bit more organized. So for instance, if you wanted to delegate a pack of drawings, you would organize yourself in a way that you are ready to delegate or to send a brief by a specific date in order for you to get the drawings back on time for the presentation or to issue to contractors. So you want to start putting a little bit more effort into the way that you're going to get organized and the due date by which you need to be ready to send your brief to the person you're delegating to, whether it's a freelancer or an outsourcing firm like ours, is absolutely essential. So you can add a due date, you can add an assignee. So if you have someone working on your team, that's the great thing. You can assign stuff to yourself and you can assign stuff to people on your team. This is status of the project, designer status, are they working on it? Delegate progress, and then you can add more columns if you want, depending on the way that you like to organize yourself with your projects. So project management admin, then the onboarding phase. So that's the first phase of the project. What do you need to be doing? So if you have a client management tool like Dubsado, all of this you can include in your workflows in Dubsado, which means that you don't really need to have that on here because it's more the client management side of things, reminding you to send a contract. So that can be part of your client management tool. But if you don't have one and you want to create to-dos as to remember everything that needs to be done, then you can also add this to your ClickUp template. And yeah, so for example, an onboarding checklist. So the great thing about ClickUp is, so everything comes as a card. So you just put your title, you can add dates, you can add a time estimate. So if you delegate to someone and you think that it's gonna take about 2 hours, you estimate 2 hours, and the freelancer or your VA or whoever you're delegating to has an idea of the time frame they need to work with. Assignee, priority, any kind of tabs. So here we put Dubsado because this is usually stuff we would be doing in Dubsado, but you can create any kind of tags that you want. You can add a description of what this card is about. You can add more details. You can create subtasks. So if you have multiple tasks within that main task, then you can create subtasks, action item, and so on. So creating checklists, you can add attachments. So everything stays in that one card, the information, the files, everything is going to be extremely easy to find and you're gonna feel in control because you're gonna become more organized. And the list view is great to get a full overview of every kind of task, the priority, the due date, etc., and the status. Then we've got the kickoff meeting. As I said, everything is easy to edit. So if this doesn't work perfectly for your process, you can update those to make it really yours. But the kickoff meeting, you can maybe remind yourself that you need to take site photos, you need to schedule the kickoff meeting. So maybe sending an email to the clients, creating a timeline, save all measurements digitally. So this is a great checklist to have. Then we get into the design phase where you're gonna start adding everything that needs to happen during the design development. So are you gonna create a presentation with 3 mood boards? So this could actually go before, this could be the first step. You're gonna start adding dates, priorities, assigning to different people, drafting, what do you need to do? You can add a link to your scope of work. So everything that you want to add to have all the information in one place, it's extremely easy to do so in those ClickUp cards. Sourcing, drafting, rendering. Then we've got the install phase. You can start adding same thing, all the things that will need to get done. What I really like about this dashboard is that you're gonna be able to add other people to it. So you could add clients. For instance, after during the design development, you could create a card with presentation number 1. So that's the first presentation. You're gonna send them 2 or 3 mood boards to kind of grasp what direction you're gonna go in for the design development, understand what they like, what they don't. And so you could easily share that card with your client and ask them to provide feedback directly on that card, which means all the communication is going to be done on that same card. There are different ways you can do it, but if you click on activity here, you're going to be able to communicate with other people, which means that if you brought your clients or your contractors or any vendors that you want to be able to communicate with directly in this ClickUp dashboard, you can tag someone and you can send comments, feedback, briefs, whatever you want. So you could create a card for your clients to provide feedback on a mood board presentation that you're sending them. They could comment directly in the ClickUp cards or send more attachments, more inspiration images, something that they found online that they really like. They can bring everything here so everything is organized and stays in the same place. And after the design phase, we've got the install and then the offboarding. So reminding yourself of everything that you need to accomplish during a project is going to ensure that you feel more in control and that you provide a top-notch client experience to your clients. The other thing that I do really love about this dashboard is that if you click on the general folder, clients, you go into calendar view, then you're going to be able to get a full overview of everything that needs to get done on all your projects. So when you have 1, 2, 3, 5, 10 clients, you can literally, by just looking at the calendar, know exactly that on project number 1, you have something to submit tomorrow. And then on project number 3, there is a client presentation on Friday. So this helps you keep a full overview of what is going on. Now, if we move on to the procurement phase, it works exactly the same way, which means that you're going to duplicate the template and then you're going to have a list for each one of your clients. So we could create a new one that's called client A. And the procurement is separated from the rest of the project simply because the procurement phase, as a designer, you know, there's a lot to think about. There's a lot going on. And well, it's actually really nice to have a full dashboard just for it. So the way that we've organized it is that and again, you can modify it to suit your projects. But for someone who is working on a big house, you can organize everything by room. So for the living room, you can start creating cards for all the products that you will need to be ordering. You can assign a task to different people. So for example, if you wanted a VA to start sourcing floor lamps, then she will know by looking at the dashboard that this is assigned to her. She will get notified that this is it's her job to be doing this. And it will be easier for you because you know that it's not something that you will be doing. You'll be focusing on the accent chairs. Then same thing, we have the status. You need to know exactly what's happening with each product. This is really handy, you know, ready to order, pending, back ordered. So it's easier for you to at a full glance, like you get a full glance of everything that's going on. Client status, has it been paid? Has a deposit been paid? Who's the vendor? What's the PO number? What's the order number? What's the carrier? When is it going to get to site? Where do you want it to be shipped? Is it going to be received in a warehouse, at your studio, at the client home? All of this is super important because you don't want to get to the install date and have the products are missing. So ensuring that everything is clear in this procurement dashboard is going to make a lot of difference. And ensure that everything is on site when it's supposed to be. And you can also assign for your VA or a designer on your team to keep track of the, you know, reach out to crate and barrel and reach out about an order that's delayed. So having all this information handy in one place is going to make you more efficient with your time. And as I said, it will look a little bit different if you're working on a commercial project, but because the template is so easy to edit, it's going to be pretty fast for you to understand what way works better. And as a designer, as a business owner, you're always going to be improving and updating the way that you work. So having the structure is enough that as you understand better what your process is going to be, the process that really works for your business, you can easily edit it so that it works as you grow. So this is what you get when you purchase our template from the shop. As I said, it's under $100 and you get this entire system. So I hope this video was helpful. If you want more information or you have questions about this template, message us down below. If you like this video, it really helps our channel. If you can like it and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.